When I think about the way we used to be, when I think about the things you took from me, I know that I am so much better, better. When I look at what I've done now that we're apart, when I look at what I've won, I've come so far. I know I'm so much better off, and baby, you don't belong. I could feel it.
What's going on, fellow reef builders? I am Jake Adams, and I'm really glad to be hitting a really good rhythm as far as bringing you guys some videos on some topics that I really, really enjoy. So one of the things that I'm working on right now is basically a review of the Aqualumination Nero 5 water pump. And you might be able to see some right here at the top and left and right of my aquarium. So I've had it on the tank for a couple days and still, you know, kind of feeling them out. But in the meantime, before I tell you what I think of the water pump, I wanted to tell you about what one of my corals thinks of the water pump. This video today is going to be all about the weeping willow leather that you can see right here. Now this coral is, it's beyond special to me because I've had it for over half of my life. There's no other coral like it. The first time that I saw the weeping willow leather coral, obviously it didn't have that name, it was just a leather coral. And I remember a couple of friends and I went to go visit a gentleman by the name of Daniel Montez. I remember we went to his house and he had a 55 gallon tank. And out of the corner of my eye, I spotted what I thought looked like a really thin tentacled anemone. And it was just a couple minutes later before we found ourselves in front of the tank, and I was absolutely floored at what I saw. It was this big leather coral with these extraordinarily long and supple tentacles that looked like an anemone. So, needless to say, arranged to get a frag of this coral and brought it home to one of my personal reef tanks and grew it out from there. So over the next few years, I kept this coral in a variety of aquariums, and I think the first aquarium, the first reef tank that it really started to kind of stand out for its unique features was Marineland Eclipse 12. What I noticed about it is that there's lots of long tentacle leather corals. There's lots of large polyp leather corals. There's plenty of big toadstools that have tentacles, you know, almost as long as this guy, 3 inches, 4 inches long. But what makes this particular strain very special, at least in my opinion, is that the polyps are so supple, not only do they just really, really flow with the current, but where the name comes from is when I would do water changes on this Eclipse 12 gallon, turn off the water flow, and these really long, supple polyps would just slowly, slowly just kind of fold over and droop over the crown of the particular leather coral, looking more or less like a weeping willow tree. So that's where the name came from. And it's a little bit amusing to see other long polyp leathers, people are just throwing the name a weeping willow on it, not really understanding, first of all, I have not shared the strain with that many people, and understanding the reasoning behind the name. So hence this video to kind of clarify the air. So when I did that water change one day, I actually took a really nice photograph, you can see here, that I submitted to the MASNA calendar contest back in 2004, 2005, and it won. I don't remember if it's first place or second place in this category, but if you have one of those really old MASNA calendars or MACNA calendars, it was in there. So for a few years there, I actually did not have any of it in my care. And I got a microscopic little encrusted piece back from my friend Rebecca Swenson, who was a boss of mine at a fish store a long time ago. And it was just a tiny little nubbin, a tiny little incrustation with just a few polyps. And you know, I kept it around in some shroom tanks and some LPS tanks and some soft coral tanks. But I never got it back to its former glory until I started putting it into high energy, high water flow, high light environments. This coral, it loves and deserves a lot of light and a lot of water flow to really, really, really do its thing. So so over the last few years, kind of we've grown it from a microscopic piece back to its full size. It's actually traveled with me to California and back. And I would say pretty much over the last years when it's seen like the most growth, particularly as I've dialed in this particular reef tank. And so like I told you, you know, what makes a true weeping willow leather is the suppleness of the polyp stalks. Turn off the flow, watch them kind of fall over and droop over the edge, looking like a weeping willow tree. As far as I know, the only person who has a frag from me from way, way, way back in the day is Sanjay Yoshi, that you can actually see in my video of his Nano Reef Tank. So yeah, this coral is really special to me because in the last 18 years, I've seen a lot of leather corals. We all have, right? And we've seen them long polyp, large polyp, even as long as this. But for some reason, even out in the wild, I've never ever encountered another sarcophyton with polyps quite as graceful as this particular leather coral. It's been with me through college, through jobs, through relationships, through highs and lows, several different states, several different moves, and it's you know, it's probably about as glorious now as I've ever had it. And you know what that means? It means it's time to frag it. So I think the next time it goes on a little temper tantrum and decides to close up for a couple days, I'm gonna use that as an opportunity just to go just give them a little trim right around the edge and make a bunch of little frags, because it's yeah, I've had this guy way too long to lose him now, and it's really about time that I share them with some of my reefing friends. So another thing, you guys keep asking, I'm not gonna sell corals, right? But this is an example of like a prize that I might bring onto the channel. If you subscribe and you're commenting, not now, but in the future, I'd rather, instead of giving you random aquarium product prizes, I'd rather give you a piece of my story in the form of a weeping willow leather coral. So that will happen someday. So I hope you enjoyed this very personal story about my weeping willow leather coral. You can see here. This guy is probably around 4 inches tall and 4 inches across, with tentacles that are good 3.5 inches long. And yeah, it's definitely time to spread them out, take some over to the studio, and just enjoy this weeping willow leather coral in a lot more aquarium. So I thought I'd just bring you this shorty video about nothing more than just a little story about one of my favorite corals. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you're appreciating, loving, and watching this steady march of videos that I'm producing for you guys. I'm really, really trying to stay in the pocket and just keep up that tempo of video releases while blogging on the website, while building the studio. So thank you so much for tuning in, and I'll be back at you in just a couple days with another great video topic. Catch you guys later.